Cause everything's wrong, nothing ain't right without you. You got me singing the blues. The moon and stars no longer shine. The dream is gone, I thought it's mine. There's nothing left for me to do but cry over you. Nothing new, why should I go? Cause I couldn't stay without you. You got to sing in the blues.
Oh, come on, Walter, lad. Look as if you're enjoying yourself.
I am. I would enjoy me all of this with you.
Now, Walter, back again, I see.
Hi.
You had half gluttons for punishment.
What are you doing with that dog on a public service vehicle?
Good to know you've not changed. It's an emergency, Hilda. The big end on my lorry's gone. Marvellous, isn't it? The roads, Walter. All a lot of roads.
I can say that again.
You got to sing the blues.
You can come out now, Tyler. Well, come on. You're being let off with a caution.
My copper runneth over.
Don't tempt me. Thank you.
He should have been charged.
Now, a couple of hours cooling off in the cells is better than dragging him in front of the beak, making him a hero.
Let me tell you something, Rowan. That man is a thug. He's malevolent, violent, and utterly antisocial.
A man who's a member of the lifeboat and Moreland rescue teams can't be all bad, Sarge. I'll keep an eye on him.
You'd best do that.
Phil, are you still on for a pint or two later?
Certainly.
Well, you best make sure your drinking boots are well dubbed.
Hello?
Excuse me, I am looking for the Aidensfield Arms.
I'll pin, I'll drop you off.
Oh, please, I do not wish to be of any trouble.
It's no trouble. Give your feet a rest.
Oh, come on, Walter. Shift yourself, lad.
I am shifting myself. It's this rucksack. It's got a life of its own.
Come on, come on. I've got a grave to dig.
What was that he said?
Oh, how should I know? I've got my hands full coping with the vagaries of this thing.
Oh, God. Walter, I didn't want to think we were going to climb Captain Junger.
Well, I'm not sure we are.
Excuse me, I wish to take a room for two or three nights.
Yeah? What's the name?
My name's Dieter Lotschmeier.
Who?
I spell it. D-I-E-T.
Kraut.
E-R.
Well, here we are then, Walter. Back again.
That's right, Hilda. Back again.
George will have our old room done out special for us.
The same old mouse droppers will be there as well.
Oh, sit down. I'm very sorry.
Who's he when he's at home?
Does it matter, Hilda? Does it really matter?
Oh. When shadows are...
Sorry, love. I should have bought you some fresh ones.
He was my father.
Well, if I were you, I'd keep quiet about it.
Yes, but I want only to pay my respects.
Well, please yourself. If you want my advice, you'll keep your head down and your mouth shut.
What's going on?
Oh, I was just trying to explain to our foreign friend here that it might be one or two people in the village not that ecstatic to see him.
Why? What's all this about then?
I asked this man if he will show me a grave. He says he will, and then he...
And then he tells me which grave it is he wants to see. You sort it out. I'm going for a pint. I've got some thirsty work to come back to.
George?
Now then, Walter, settled in, have you?
Aye, just about. The usual, George. Glucose start for Hilda, pint a mile for me.
Never varies, eh? Do you know, I find in a changing world that very comforting, very reassuring.
This is the grave I look for. My father's. He came from Germany.
Why is he buried here?
In the war, he was a bomber pilot.
In the Luftwaffe?
He flew on a raid over England. His plane crashed. I never knew how he was killed until last month. My mother died. I went through her papers.
What have you been doing, Nick? Eh? I've been waiting ages for you, pup.
I'm sorry, mate, I got delayed. We're off to the pub if you fancy a good English pint.
What's this on my own?
George, oh, Walter. Scotch. Sleep.
I thought you were digging a grave.
Yep, marked it out. You have to pace yourself, you know. It's hard work digging graves. I'm just glad I shan't be around when it comes to digging mine. Anyway, how you doing? All right?
Oh, so-so.
How long is it you and your missus have been coming here now?
50 years to the day. We come here for our honeymoon night.
Did you? I wondered where those cracks in the ceiling came from.
Just ignore them, Walter. I think it's very romantic.
Romantic? How do you mean?
You know.
No, I don't. What's she talking about?
It's women's talk.
Oh, that.
Here we are, Walter. On the house. Celebrate your half century.
Oh, thank you very much. Very nice of you. I need to have had a cyanide to celebrate that. Come in, love.
You lot in World Cup. Red hot.
Excuse me?
Fritz Walter. Good play.
Let's see. Let's
ride out. Oi! Tyler!
Oh, me?
That bike's too noisy and you were speeding.
Was that Hecker's Lake?
This is the last warning. Get that bike seen to. If I catch you speeding again, you're nicked. All right? Glad he lives in Whitby.
Oh, I just told him to keep his head down, you know. Hey, oh, this is him. I'm off.
What are we drinking then, Dieter?
I shall drink what you drink.
Three of the usual, please.
Have you noticed? There's a nasty smell suddenly turned up around here.
And what makes you say that, Joseph? He's a visitor. It's free country, you know.
Aye. But we know his dad was.
Aye. That German bomber pilot flew his plane over here during the war.
And we all know what happened then. Aye. Don't we, Tyler?
I will go to my room. 2 minutes, then I'll return and we will drink.
What's wrong with you all? His father's buried in the churchyard. Anything wrong with that? It happens, you know. People die, then they get buried.
There's something you don't know, Nick. Before he crashed, the pilot dropped a bomb.
Aye. And it landed right on poor old Joe Tyler's house. It killed him and his missus stone dead.
The lad wasn't there. He was stopping with his auntie in Middlesbrough.
You see? I told you there was a nasty smell round here.
Right, that's it. On your feet.
What to do?
I'll tell you what's to do. I think it's a downright disgrace.
What?
No arguing, on your feet. Us having to sleep the night under the same roof as a German at our age. Come on.
You're talking rubbish.
No such thing. Some of us have got memories, Walter.
What memories?
Sheffield, the Blitz.
Excuse me, please.
Sorry.
Excuse me, please. I wish to pass.
I'm sorry. I can't understand what you're saying. Can you understand what he's saying?
Or a blooming word.
It escaped your notice, Walter. But during the war, Jerry almost wiped Sheffield off the face of the earth. What did you do about it? Nothing.
Oh, give it a rest, Hilda.
Came swooping down Wicker with his bombers. Blew all our windows in and shattered the slates on the coal shed roof.
Well, you should have written to Whitler about it.
Excuse me, please. I wish to go to the bar.
Hey! Now he has a language that we'll both understand. You're German and I'm English. Your lot killed our lot. Am I making myself clear?
Okay.
All right, that's enough. That's enough.
All right, man.
I'm coming outside. That's
all right. I'm going. It's marvellous, this, isn't it? Eh? An Englishman turfed out of an English pub because a German...
All right, out. I hope you're pleased with yourself, mate. I hope you're proud of what you've done.
When the girl in your...
Always does us good here, doesn't it, Walter? The great outdoors, tramping the moors, fresh air blowing the cobwebs off you. Come to bed, Walter. Walter.
So her time and never let her go. Day and night.
Do you remember when you first came to my bed on our honeymoon night?
Vividly.
What were you thinking, love? Spend
a life. I was thinking I wish to God I was somewhere else.
What?
I was thinking I wish I was on the Orient Express.
The Orient Express?
Aye. With gunrunners from the Levant with gold teeth and countesses and gigolos and slinky beauties from the East with ginormous rubies glistening in the navels.
Would I have been there, Walter?
It's funny, isn't it? I never did know the Ordnance Survey symbol for an unmanned level crossing.
Make her yours forever.
There's no need to whisper.
I hear there's a German in the village.
No, told you that.
Rita popped in, said he's staying at the Aidensfield Arms. Bit off, isn't it?
Well, I don't see why.
We're having the enemy in our midst.
The enemy? The war is over, Eileen. We've stopped shooting each other. Now, his father was killed during the war, and so was mine.
Sorry.
Yeah, well, he seems a decent bloke, that's all.
Oh.
Come on, Walter! Walter!
What I can't fathom is, what good does he think it can do raking up old memories like what happened to the plane, what happened to the pilot?
Well, what did happen?
It's only hearsay, like, you know, I mean, I wasn't there.
You're looking a bit shifty, Claude.
I just remembered something. The good lady herself. Now then, all ready for the off, Hilda?
That's right. You've got a horrible day for it. Oh, don't matter me one way or t'other, love. Rain, hail. It's fresh air what counts when you come from a mucky old city like us. Ah, where are you, Walter? He's getting slow in his ways, you know. Thought about buying him a budgie, but... Oh, there you are, love. Ready for the off, are you?
No.
No?
No, I'm not ready for the off.
Oh, what's the wheel, then?
I have seen the light.
What light?
The light of my misery.
What misery?
The misery of being with you on holiday.
What?
50 years of it I've had. 50 years of plodding round them moors like a demented coolie. 50 years of relentless grass and relentless scenery. 50 years when I could have been having wild and wicked adventures on the Orient Express, dressed in no but fluffy carpet slippers, paisley muffler and an ebony cigarette holder. Well then, failing all that, I, Walter Openshaw, shall now do the next best thing. Gosh. I intend to stay here now and each morning henceforth and get myself well and truly transmogrified with my good friend here, Claude Greengrass. So, Gina, will you kindly do the honours? Thank you.
Oh, you're all right.
Yeah, that's better. Do you like those?
I have flowers too, for my father.
So I see.
I hope last night I did not make a nuisance of myself.
Forget it, Dieter.
That man Tyler, why was he so angry with me?
I should leave it. You're best off not getting involved.
I wish to see where my father's plane crashed.
I'm not sure that's such a good idea, Dieter.
Vandalism, I abhor. The fact that the victim was a German is no concern of mine. But what does concern me is that this should happen on our patch. Am I right?
Yes, Sarge.
What was a German doing being buried in a decent, God-fearing English graveyard? That's what I'd like to know.
Oh, I can put you in the picture there, Sarge.
My word, Ventress. The floor is yours.
Well, there's not a lot to say, really, Sarge. When the plane crashed, they only found the pilot's body. The military buried him in Aidensfield graveyard. Last post, volley of rifles, wreath. Well, it split the village in two, Sarge.
Well, we're not having a split now. I want the culprit found. Fast. I'm a fair man and an impartial upholder of the laws of the land, and thus... There's only one further thing to say on this subject.
Yes, yes, Sarge.
Thank God he wasn't a Jap.
He never said out to me. All them years and he never said a word.
Well, that's typical of men. They'd rather chunter and brood in silence.
What do you mean?
Well, the slightest tint of a scene, you'll not see the backsides of a dust. Anything for a quiet life.
But it seems my Walter never wanted a quiet life.
Oh, calm down, Hilda. You're just a little bit over. Nothing to worry about.
It's just that I feel so weak.
Yes, well, we all feel like that when we're betrayed by somebody we love.
Love?
Who said anything about love?
50 years of sheer hell it's been.
I know, but marriage is like that, Walter. That's why I'm not.
I'm not talking about marriage. That's not so bad, apart from a gravy. I'm talking about holidays. You see, that's why I like trains, because trains take me where I want to go. Not hiking. I mean, who in the right mind wants to go hiking every year?
Well, certainly nobody like we're going to be if we keep this up.
What's that?
Legless.
You off to Whitby, then?
Why Whitby?
We'll see Tyler.
No, he's too obvious. You see the faces in the pub last night?
Yeah. What about them?
Well, there was real hate there. Don't often see that in the village, do you?
Yeah. You think things would have changed by now?
There's a great big world out there yonder, Claude. There's adventure and romance.
Is there?
The cry of the curlew? Rubbish. The purple bloom of the heather, all rubbish. What I wanted was the aroma of fat Turkish cigarettes and the rasp of a sheer silk stocking. And
another pint of mild.
Aye, another pint will do. That's favourite.
I saw note and heard note. When I left the pub, I went straight home and took myself into bed.
So did I. Mind you?
What do you mean, mind you?
Oh, no. We'd better go.
You want to get out of it, Walter. Make your escape while you've still got time.
Escape? Where to?
Leave that to me, old lad. Come here.
Hello, Junior. George. Tell me the gossip about the grave.
That German turning up has upset a lot of people. One half of the village says serves him right, and the other half says live and let live.
And you?
Oh, come on, Nick. I'm the landlord. I don't take sides.
Well, why don't you ask our friendly neighbour, Gravedigger, over there? I mean, he hasn't stopped going on about this plane crash since Dieter turned up.
On top of the end.
Cool. Quiet word, please. Outside.
I can't tell you, because I wasn't there when the plane crashed, was I? I was miles away. In foreign clime, serving me country.
Yeah, of course you were, Claude. Catterick, wasn't it?
It's all right, you can mock. We also served even in the catering corps, after we'd done the cooking.
So where were you last night, say, midnight till dawn?
I was brooding about the injustices of life.
What injustices?
Well, let's face it, there's been more fuss made about that German's grave than there ever was.
All right, Claude. Now tell me exactly where you were doing all this brooding.
Have you spoken to the vicar?
I've spoken to half the village, Eileen.
No one's seen anything?
Nothing. It's like a wall of silence out there.
What about Claude Greengrass?
Yeah, well, I think he's hiding something. Just got to find out what. I think I'll try Whitby first, have a word with Tyler.
Your heart's not in this case, is it?
No. No, look at Katie and I think, why bother? Why harp on about the past? It's the future we should be looking to.
I know, love. But the past has a funny old habit of catching up with the future, hasn't it?
I need to find him.
Who?
The man who caused all the trouble last night.
Look, don't bother.
Why do you want to see him?
I need to speak to him, to explain.
You'll find him in Whitby. He works in the old curing sheds. There's a bus due soon. I'd hop on it if I was you. I'm sure young Tyler will be delighted to see you.
Goodbye.
You louse, Tom Gordon. You rotten louse.
When you walk through a storm, hold your hand up high, and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end.
Peter.
What are you doing here?
I come to speak to Tyler.
Don't go and see him.
But I want to tell him we are a new generation. Why hate? We must forgive, do you understand?
Yeah, I understand, but I don't think our friend Tyler would.
He would if I could talk to him.
Look, Dieter, your father.
What?
He dropped a bomb round here to lighten the load. It could have landed anywhere, but it landed on Tyler's cottage. Both his parents were killed.
I did not know. I'm very sorry.
Well, it's not took long for them to tidy it up.
Too true, Tom. I wonder how long they'd have taken if it had been one of our boys.
Aye. You're right there, Joseph, old lad.
Why? Why did my father drop that bomb?
I think that's the question Tyler's been asking himself all these years. There's your bus back to Aidensfield. Forget about talking to Tyler. He won't want to know.
I know why you're here.
Oh, yeah?
The German. You've come to talk about that German and how the grave got vandalised.
And how would you know about that?
Well, I don't know if you know this, but we've got a new invention round here. And if you pick it up, you can talk through one end and listen through the other.
Don't get sarky with me, Tyler. So where were you last night when the grave was vandalised?
I was on the lifeboat. I'm crew, remember? Some people save lives, some people wipe them out. Check it out, PC Rowan.
Oh, I just want to see what they've done. Look at that. You know what's going to happen here, don't you?
What?
That Blaketon's going to find some way of blaming me for doing this.
No, it couldn't possibly be you.
Well, hey, you know that and I know that, but I bet you any money you like. Anyway. Come on.
Where are we going?
Leave it to me.
Come on. Oh, he'll love my guts for garters.
I've checked it, Sarge. A Danish coaster in difficulties.
I don't want to know, Rome. We've got another crisis on our hands. He's done a bunk.
Who?
Walter Openshaw, our ancient Iker from the Aidensfield Arms. 50 years he's been going there without a hint of trouble, and now he's legged it. With £5 from George's till. Read that. He left it for his wife.
Hilda, I have left you for good and I've already embarked on my last hike across the moors. By the time you read this, I shall be long gone. Good luck. I remain your husband, Walter Openshaw.
You'd best find him, Rowan, because if you don't, there'll be another grave in the graveyard. And I won't guarantee whose body will be lying in it.
Right then, you got the roots? I expect you all back here at 6:30, prompt. Is that understood?
Sarge.
Right. Excuse me, sir.
What do you want?
I should like to help the finding.
Oh, I see. You should like to help the finding, eh? Don't you think you've caused enough trouble round here already? Just make yourself scarce.
Pardon me?
Sling your hook. Right, I'm going back to man the station.
Oh, yes, Sarge. Do you good to stay in the warm.
And Rowan?
Sarge?
Make sure you take good care of the district nurse there.
Him take care of me? You've got to be joking.
I didn't think you'd show up.
I'm part of your group, PC, Rowan. Volunteer. It's in the blood, you see. Can't keep me away.
Walter!
Oh. It's Robert Shaw!
Walter!
Where are you, Walter?
Come on, Phil. What's to do with you?
What's to do with me? I'm missing out on a dead cert at the dance tonight. That's what's to do with me. Now, come on. As soon as we find the old fool, the better.
So how'd you get here, then?
Train and ferry.
Oh, couldn't go on a boat, me. Get terrible seasick.
Can a man get a drink around here? And am I interrupting a private conversation?
Same again, Joseph.
Aye. Go on.
I don't think you're too popular around here, do you?
No.
Take no notice of them. It's not that you're German, it's that you're different.
I don't understand.
Well, you see, being different from these parts is an unforgivable sin.
Hello, Gina.
Hiya.
Maggie asked me to pop in and see how Hilda is.
Oh, she's upstairs in room 7. How's Katie?
Fine. She's with Rita this afternoon.
I do not want to be different.
What?
I must go to help with the finding. Sorry.
Crats. Why don't they go home and leave us in peace?
Walter!
Walter!
Hold on. We're going the wrong way.
And what makes you say that?
Because I know these moors. A townie like Walter, he'd stick to the contours of the land. He wouldn't be fighting them like what we're doing. He'd have taken that path there, yonder.
But our instructions are to go this way.
Here's yourself. It's no to do with me.
Nick.
All right, then. We'll bow to the expert.
They'll never find him alive. I know him too well. He'll go and get himself killed fatal just to spite me.
You mustn't talk like that. I know men can get up to some strange things, but I'm pretty sure in the main death comes fairly low on their agenda.
You don't know Walter.
Well, that's true.
Why did he never tell me? I thought the holidays were the highlight of his life.
Maybe they were. Maybe being miserable and resentful was the highlight of his life.
See? Told you we're on the right track.
Well, let's hope so.
What are you doing?
I'm getting something I'd forgotten all about.
Where are we going?
Paradise.
Paradise is too far for people like us.
Come on, Walter. You made your break for freedom. You can't back out now.
What have you got there?
Provisions for paradise. Come on, let's get cracking.
Okay.
How was I to know he had this yearning to hobnob with gunrunners on the Orient Express? To think he kept it a secret for 50 years. Why didn't he come out into the open with it?
Openness isn't always a good thing in marriage, you know.
What do you mean?
I wish I hadn't known about my husband's little weakness.
Oh, what was that?
Philandering.
Oh, my Walter don't philander. He wouldn't know how.
He'll be back. You do want him back, don't you? Hilda?
The Orient Express. To think he used to be sick on the slow stop at Highland Common.
Come on, Walter, where's your get up and go? Get up and gone.
Are we nearly there?
On the last lap, all that. Come on. Oh.
Somewhere.
What's he up to?
He was brought up here. This used to be his home till the Kraut's plane turned up and blew it sky high. He's rebuilding it in his spare time.
Strictly medicinal, lads. Tom?
No, Tom. Come on. Thanks, Maggie.
Look, Maggie, I'm sorry for some of the things I said.
It's all forgotten.
No, I was wrong. Especially after the funeral.
Honestly, it's all forgotten, Nick.
Kate and I came up here once for a picnic.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, she loved it. Said we'd come back. We never got around to it.
Get yourself killed. The lethal other bogs round here.
They'll drag you down without trace.
So what are we going to do?
Leave him.
What?
Leave him.
There's not we can do.
Tom, go and fetch one of those ladders. Well, go on. You.
Yeah?
Give me that rope.
Why should I?
Because, as you keep telling everyone, you save lives. You're Moreland Rescue, or aren't you?
Because of the Iceman! Help!
What a sign of him. What a caper, eh?
He'll be back at my place.
You what?
In the bar, supping his ale. And she'll be sat alongside him, guzzling a glucose stout.
I'll throw him if he is.
Nick's taking his time. Blake will go spare.
How can you, of all people, stand by and watch?
Hang on there, Dita.
Stop where you are. You're doing it all wrong. Move this ladder over here. Here, give us a hand with this one.
My Maylon!
There, Walter. How's that for paradise?
Bye. Look at that!
Try not to move.
Stay calm, Dieter.
Get as far down the ladder as you can. That's it, come on!
The Führer in. The force is sweetheart. Go.
Can you get your hand out? That's it, come on!
Use your hand, Dieter. This one.
Give him your hand. This that's one. It! This one. That's it! Go on!
That's it, hold on!
Come on! Go on! Go on! Go on! Come on!
That's it, careful with him!
Come on, Dieter!
Like a lady's boudoir. Oh, Vera's boudoir. What? My dream, this, my lifelong dream.
Trains, steam engines. Hilda never understood. She wanted me to be a war hero.
Mom, let's get you into the war.
Thank you. It's not me you are, then. It's him. Thank you. All right, we should get back to the rendezvous point.
What are you doing?
I'm inspecting my yard.
Here.
Get yourself outside of that.
Hey, this label, it's wrote in German.
And of course it's wrote in German, it's because it snaps. It should be nice and mature. It's over 20 years old.
Oh, kindred spirit. I wonder what this object does.
Hey, up. What's going on down there?
Isn't that Claude Greengrass hanging out of the cab?
They've never nicked the train.
Ah, oh, that's all we need. I'll try and cut him off.
Oh, we'll meet again. I don't know when. But oh, we'll meet again some sunny day.
Stop it!
Well, gentlemen, I think a few explanations are in order, don't you?
Hijacked. A steam locomotive, hijacked on my patch, with Claude Jeremiah Greengrass as an accessory, and what happens? I have to hand you over to the British Transport Police. I can only pray the punishment will fit the crime.
It was worth it, whatever happened.
Shut up.
I see. Right, Rowan.
Yeah, one ornamental dagger, German. One cigarette case, German. One empty bottle of schnapps, German.
All right. I were the first then after the plane had crashed.
And in a sudden blinding flash of patriotic fervour, you decided to pilfer the body.
What are you on about? I'm no body robber. I mean, I know I might have been guilty of the odd discretion now and again, but I wouldn't do out like that.
So where'd you get all this lot from?
Well, scattered all over the place.
No reason to nick the stuff, is there?
No, I know, but it's a long time ago, but if I remember rightly, I took it so I'd have something to show to the younger generation, you know, to point out the folly and futility of war. You don't believe me, do you?
How well you know me, Greengrass. How well you understand my nature. As for you...
We found that £5 note on him, Sarge. Still intact. George isn't going to press charges.
Oh, really? How very friendly.
There is something else, though, Sarge.
What?
That note we found on the grave and the note that Walter wrote to his wife. Same handwriting.
Well, well, well. I'm waiting.
It was me. I did it for Hilda.
Why?
I thought she might like that.
Did she?
She were thrilled. She said whoever wrecked that grave is a hero. One of these days I might tell her it were me.
Really?
Well, on the other hand, I might keep quiet about it. Well, it don't do for a man to show off in front of his wife, does it?
Thank you very much for everything.
Ta-ra, Dieter. You're a nice bloke. Even if you are German.
Right then. Shall we be seeing you again next year?
Aye. Go on then.
Oh,
get
my hero.
I don't know. All that's happened to them, and they're still coming back next year.
Remind me to book my leave.
Right.
You fancy a drink later?
So long as it's not a glucose stout.